I'm going to talk about our roots, where we are coming from the beginning. And it's talking about that Jesus must have been dark-skinned, and brown-skinned at least, that he was born in that area that people were had more color in their skin and was not white, as the picture showing. And it happened. I'm not going to talk about my story here. It's about the subject of knowing your roots. And it was in 2016. I had first when I was in Sweden, I was feeling, I had started to feel that God want me to do things. I didn't hear from him anymore, but I knew what to do. And so I knew I should go to Israel. And then I should go and meet a man in Israel. I knew that from God, but he had not talked to me. It only was inside my mind to do it. And I didn't have any money to take a flight to Israel. So it must happen something, because I have experienced that if God want me to travel somewhere, he makes sure that I get money to buy me a ticket. And I was in 2013, I was in Africa, in Kenya, and that's money I got from, like, supernatural source, but it was from God's source, but it was money I got that I didn't had, and I could take the flight and be in Kenya for 3 weeks. And then I got money from it took only one day when I knew I should fly to Israel, that a man was talking to me, and I say that I feel that I have to go to Israel. And he say that, oh, I wish I could go with you, he say. But he was mentally sick, so he couldn't. He was frightened to take a flight. But he say that, I want to go with you. I give you money for the flight ticket, and then also that you can buy a tablet, a surf tablet, to recording what you are doing in Israel. And that's the tablet is where I am talking to now. I'm recording on this tablet that I could buy from that money I got from this man. And I could fly, and I could stay at the hotel for that money. And I come to hotel in Tel Aviv, Israel, and I had a name of that man I should meet, and I didn't know anything about that man. But I asked at the hotel if they could call this man, because I didn't know how to call in a phone, in an ordinary telephone, because I couldn't use mine. And so they did that, and they'd be surprised when I asked for this man's name, because he was very famous in Israel. And they called him up, and he was at home, and we make an appointment when I should go to his home. And I order a taxi, and I travel from Tel Aviv up to the north of Israel to I have forgot what's name, but is this where there is always dangerous to go, but the city's name was Holon, and I was going there, and this man, he told me that he have written a book about they belong, these tribes that he belonged to, their name, the tribe's name was Israeli Samarian, and they claim to have been to with Moses in the desert for 40 years, those people that come out from Egypt. And I asked him if he could write the book of my life, of my walking under God. And he said that I have already written my book for my lifetime. He was old man, and so he didn't want to do it. He said that he have translate their Torah, their book. They have the Torah book. They follow Jewish tradition, but also they have their own history. And he have written it down and into English. And then he traveled all over the world and selling this book. So only that is very strange, that he was at home. He could have been in New York. He could have been everywhere. But he was at home. So I was to his home. And then it's these spirit things that happen, that I say to him that you are from Egypt, I say. And he laughs and he say, how do you know that? I say, that's because God told me that you are from Egypt. And he was from Egypt. He was born in Egypt, but have moved to Israel. And then he asked me, why did you come here? I said that God told me that I should go here. But how did you know who I am and where I live? I said, God told me. And he didn't understand, because these people, They only read books. They don't see what's going on in the spirit world, in around us. They only focus on books. So he didn't understand that I was there. God have sent me to him. Even if I have told him that he is from Egypt, and I couldn't know that, and that I have found him, but he didn't understood, and that's it's very sad that people don't understand that I am under God, and God tell me what to do, and I do it. And I had learned to, when God is saying something, I have to move very fast. It's going very fast to make the decision. It's only to obey, or else it can go away if we are too slow to react on it. And it was reaction, but it was coming from God that I got this money. And it's only when God was telling me to go to Israel. It took me about 1 week, and then I was in Israel from having nothing, no money, and not have thinking that I should go. And I have not travel in my own will. I have traveled in God's will all the time, and it have taken me to many countries. And before I took the flight to Israel, I asked on internet, what should I do in Israel? Is it something interesting I can look at and visit? And then it was that I have been to Israel twice before 2016. I was in Israel 2011 and 2013. And now I was the third time in Israel, so I have visited many places. So I'm wondering what I should visit this time when I'm in Israel, not only visit this man. And so somewhere it's come that I should go to a museum, and I don't know who say that. It was only something. I seldom got any reaction from people to help me. So that was very strange. I don't know who gave me that I should go to a museum that have just opened, that this person wanted me to go there. And I see it as it was God that was sending me this message. And so I pay for a ticket, because we had to stay in line. We have to have a scheduled time when to go there. And so I order a taxi in Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, and I had to do that. I could have gone with a bus, but I have to be in time for the ticket, for the schedule time. And I didn't know. I only knew the name of the museum. And I walk in there to the museum, And a young man was standing there and looked at my ticket. And when he looked at my ticket, I asked him, what is this museum? What is it about? As I asked him. And he looked at me like, do you pay for a ticket to a museum that you don't know, like that? He looked like that in his face. And he said, this museum is about the friends of Zion, Zion's friends museum. Friends of Science Museum is the name of it. And when he say that, I get into really spirit mood. So he thought I should faint. So he asked me, do you want some water? Should I go and get some water? He said to me, but it was a spirit thing. It hit me very much, the spirit. And so I was knocked down a little. But I said to him, I'm fine. I'm okay. It was a spirit thing that happened to me. So I was in the right place that I understood. And then they took a picture. We were only four visitors, and because it was not so known museum in that time, because it was just have open, and they took a picture of each of us, and I wonder why do they take picture, but I come to know it then. We were walking around in a museum, and it was about how Muslims and Christian people and Jewish people, they work together to build up the Palestine area after the war. And it was just 1948 there, around there. And it was very interesting for me, that is technical, interested person. And because it was a laser done, and it was 3D pictures and movies and touch screens, and it was very much technical. And then in the end of the we have a guide that walking with us, and in the end of the guide tour, we sit down and saw a 3D movie, and it was a tree first, and then from the tree come picture of people. First it come the people we didn't know, but then it come famous people that we know about, and in the end there was our picture that come. My picture come out from the tree in 3D style, so it's like it touch me like that. And a voice say, I don't know if it was the museum voice or it was a spirit voice, that say loudly that we all are connected to in one way or another way. All of us, all over the world, are connected. We are brothers and sisters. We all are. And I felt like I must do my family tree. I must do DNA test, and it have just started to be popular, to be known that you can take a DNA test. It was 2016. And I went home, and I didn't have much money left after being to Israel. But I take a little water. But I knew I have to do it immediately. So I didn't know how to survive, because I had nothing to eat, but I did it anyway. I paid for a DNA test. I knew that I have to do I couldn't wait for my ordinary money to come, my retirement money to come. I have to do it as soon as I come home. So I sent it. It was sent to Ireland, and then I got my result. And I was thinking that I had this thinking about my mother have done the family tree once in the 70s, but in that time they took everything from the books, but now they took every information from my DNA, and I'd be very, very surprised that I had so much people. I thought no one have moved to America. I thought everyone was in Sweden, but then it's come all over the world. There was even in a small country like Greenland, I have my DNA, and I have very much from Maya Indians, and then I saw that the longest down roots I had, it was in Africa, and I couldn't have done it later on, because today it's I can't see the roots anymore, because so many people have done DNA test, so they have taken the tracks away. It's too much branches now, but I could see the whole way down to Africa, and I was from Tanzania and South Africa and Congo, a small tribes in Congo they are very short. They are pygmy. They are they are very short people, and I'm kidding with people who say that's why I am so short, because my DNA is from those small people in Congo's jungle, and I could follow the tracks they were walking, how they come up to Israel, to Palestine, and I understood that God wanted to show me that it started in Africa. It started the human roots are from Africa, and then the those people from Africa walking up to the North Africa and come to Israel and Palestine. And I had one group that was going to Israel, and then they come up to Russia, and then up to Finland, and over to Sweden. And that's, I'd be surprised that it was my father's track, the walk. My mother, her DNA, they come in up to North Africa, to Algeria, and over to Italy and France. And that's from my mother's side. I have that Jewish. I have 25% Jewish DNA. And my father, he was from Russia, Finland, and going over to Sweden. And he's dead, but he had blonde hair and blue eyes. My mother had green brown eyes and black hair, and so she's so very Jewish. And I have talked to Jewish people about it, and they don't like that I say that that they look special, those that I'm Jewish. But I say origin Jewish, how they look like. That's how my mother looked like. So I'm just a mix of my father and mother, and the DNA was also spread to Peru, South America, to the Maya Indians, and so there. For long time ago, they belong, everyone that's on the North Slavic countries. They were together. The land was going together, so they could walk around. So they look the same. The Peru Indians and the Navajo people in United States, the Indians there, and also Sweden with the Nordic people up in the north, that is Finland and Russia and Norway together, they also look the same as this, like Asia style. So that's, I knew that I come from, and I saw in my DNA that was all over the world, just like the voice had told me in Jerusalem. And I understood the history also. I have not been so much into history, but I saw that my mother, they have the DNA from Scotland, Ireland, and England, and some ancestors far away. They were with the royals in England and Scotland, and then my father's line that was in Russia, I saw that everything was together. All those royals in the past time, they were together. It's like everyone is have the same DNA in them. And I belong to that network of DNA. And then also in Israel at the hotel, I was taking the bus, the city bus. So I was traveling with the bus, and on the bus stop at the hotel, and where I was standing, it's the bus stop name was Rothschild Street, and I saw that street was very long and very wide, and it was going through the whole Tel Aviv, and I was wondering, what's special with that street? And then I come to know that Rothschild and Russia family and the English royal family are together, and Rothschild is the most powerful family on this planet, because they rule the money, the financial, all over the world, and I know this about President Trump, that he is involved in this network of financial money power. And it's scaring to know that they rule the whole world. The money rules the whole world just now. I'm not religious. I only know God exists, and that he am in control, total control. But even if he is in control, there is movement going on today that is evil going on. But it's something that God knows about. He knows that from the beginning, this what going to happen. And it's for a reason. And this planet is only to test us. It's only to test for what, you ask. The what I come to know that is the test, because it's only not only this planet, it's the whole universe. It's a war, not only target our planet. It's who is going to take control over the whole universe. So in that way, here on Earth, we are chosen to be tested, to see who am strong enough, who am the survivor, who am when you are hit and we break down, and people around you be killed, and everything fall apart in your life. Are you a survivor, or are you a complainer? Are you going to be bitter angry at God and see everything in darkness, then you are in the darkness. Then you are a child of the devil. And God tests us that we see who is the survivor that can be stronger of losing everything. Like for me, when I come back from United States and been homeless, I had no job and I had no home and I had no money and I still was homeless in Sweden also when I come back for a while until I get a home to have my own home. I was staying in a hotel that they pay for a time until I could prove that I could be in a rent apartment. I have to be with those homeless in Sweden to prove that I was okay. And that was also a test. And I could hold out and they see that I was not doing any drugs or was drinking or was mental sick, because they never could understood that I had by my own will, as it's looked like, that I was in United States and was homeless. They didn't even want to accept it, even if I showed them that my payout checks in United States when I have been working, that I have got money in United States from work. And they never thought that. And they was thinking I was like all the other homeless, that I was either doing drugs, drinking, or was mental sick. And so I got a home. But I survived. I could have many times when I was homeless and walk in Florida, and the doors was open to bars, and I was thinking, I had that thought that I could go into a bar and get me a man and have maybe some food to eat and a bed for that night. But I never did it. I hold out. The devil have those open doors to the bars. I could get everything if I was going into the bar, but I have to walk away from God and His will. And I never did that. I was a survivor. I am a survivor. I'm not angry and bitter because I lost everything. I lost everything when I decided to walk under God. But in another way, I got everything. I got life. I should have been dead in year 2000 if not God have coming and taken me, pick me. I chose life. And I gain life and gain the spirit, understanding, the spirit knowledge. And now I'm so high up in the in the holy mountains, or you know, the visitors is coming here, and they are coming through now, because I think I triggered them by saying this about spirit things. There is an old man is coming here now. He's a very powerful man. He's like we have seen from the Vikings' time, as far away he's coming from. And he said, the mood swing. There must be a balance, he's saying this to you. There is an exercise to exercise your mood swing to get control and get balance. And that's started with your life. That there is no time to play, he say. The brainstorm, he's saying. He's coming from the behind the wheel, so it's a little stop in the talking also. But I see if I can put together everything that he's saying. He say brainstorm. And he say that you call it today mapping, mind mapping. That you need to focus what's most important in life. It's going to be cold. It's going to be cold. You are freezing. You're freezing. You can't move. You can't move because you are freezing up. And you need to have, before you freezing up, is he saying, you need to make action, because the winter, and it's not about winter season, it's about winter in the spirit, it's coming. That's why he look like he have a big coat, warm coat on him. He's showing that the cold is coming. And now again he is talking about this to be prepared. It's not only in natural things, he say, it's also in your mind to be prepared. People are too weak, he's saying, because their mind is not set up for the season to come, the winter. So the whole time they are talking about something in the future that will come, and It's not far away. It's closed. It's very narrow. It's on its way to coming. So, is it about the election of in the United States? No, it's not about that, you say. I wish I could ask him questions. Can you tell something more specific what's going to happen? You will see, he say. Can't you say anything more about signs to watch for? He's showing me it's like rain. It's coming from the sky. It's now he's showing me so I can see now. It's like angels that is coming down, and it's coming like a hail, very hard to hit here. So when will it come? So he say very soon, he's saying. So it's going, is on its way to coming. And now he's saying, it's no matter about time, he say, very quick or hard, he say. It's about to be prepared, he say. He be irritated on me. Because it's not about time, it's about to be prepared. So I get it. I got it. Thank you. Thank you very much for telling us. I'm happy that I get visitors to tell me, and I feel I was alone before, but now I don't feel alone anymore, because I can tell there is people that's coming here and talking. So I know my family in heaven. So, and thank you for listen. And I hope you learn something from what I'm talking about. So God bless you. Thank you.